The safety of the vehicle, the position of the vehicle, it'll be looking for any dangers, whether that'll be, you know, be an LPG vehicle, or a diesel vehicle, or a petrol vehicle. They'll start talking to the casualty, assessing the scene, and then they'll start to think of a plan. They'll start to think of a plan how to extricate the casualty from the vehicle in the safest and quickest way. So we'll always work alongside the police and the ambulance that are here today. The police and the ambulance are here today, so the police will close the road and they'll be looking at any evidence that can be gathered in the incident. And the ambulance service will be in attendance, monitoring and checking the casualty and informing the firefighters how quickly the casualty will need to come out of the vehicle. So you've already started to see there's quite a big difference here. Crews have already started to get to work. They're stabilising the vehicle, that's what the orange blocks are underneath. That's to give us a stable platform to work off. I think that's Firefighter Williamson in the back there now. So we more actively now use hand tools. So we use any drill bits or torques, screwdrivers, spanners, as quiet as we can to make as much space as we can. So you'll see now both moving both the back doors of the van. We've got a nice big space there where if we needed to get the casualty out, we can get the casualty straight out through the back doors of the van. But we're not going to do that today. We're going to go for what we call full access. So at this moment in time, we'll see two firefighters there working well together, removing the driver's door. So we're using battery-operated cutting equipment, brand new equipment, very good, very efficient. We no longer have generators with hydraulic cables. Very effective, quick to get to work, very light. If you were here this morning, you would have seen the fire cadet using the same equipment. So now we can see the casualty sat in there. In front of him on the steering wheel is a red bag. That's covering the airbag. And that is preventing the airbag from redeploying again. So it's kept him safe in the event of an accident, but we wouldn't want it to activate when there's firefighters in there working. So we cover the airbag steering wheel, and that will contain it in the event of a deployment. So you'll see firefighters used now at the back of the van. So he's using the cutters and the motor tool there to start crushing the back. And then that noise, which you can still hear here, is a ripsaw that will be used to cut through all the way through the side of the van, right up to the windpost. So this is the easiest demonstration to deliver. This is definitely not as easy as a normal car. So once seize is made, that initial crash, the cutters will go in, start to crash and cut the seam post, and then the ripsaw will hopefully go all the way through the inside of the van and turn it into a convertible. And you'll see Firefighter Santa there walking around with what looks like a blue shield, and that's something that we call a teardrop. And we put that in place to protect the casualty whenever we're operating tools. So if there was anything that was to fly around with his mouth, that shield would protect the casualty. So you hear the ripsaw now working away. Now we're asking a lot here for the ripsaw to come through this. Now as you can imagine, it's quite warm today. Now coming in with the cutters, so he's going to start cutting that back C post. The other firefighter, Hughes, the other side, she's concentrating now on the B post. And then the final cut to her make of what we call the A post, which will be at the front there of the van. The one's on the windscreen. A lot of talking, we share ideas with each other, we bounce experience after each other, we've learned from different jobs, we will share those experiences, learn from each other. So as you can see, that's as far as we don't just put out fires. There's many strings to our bow. Road traffic collisions, floodings, animal rescues, water rescues. The list goes on. Start work on the one side now, and Josh is just going to start to work on this side now. So by no means is this an easy task. This is a hard work. Similar to a tin opener, very effective, cut through single sheet metal very quickly, no noise. Just purely hard work from crew manager Ben. And I'll follow all the way up to the cut with the cutters. Passenger doors now been removed, that's come off as well. So we're on the last hurdle now. And when we also found out we were doing the open day, I said to them, did they want to do something nice and easy? And they said, no, we want to give you the full demonstration. Give us something hard. So I arranged a van for them. And you should have seen their happy smiley faces when this van turned up. It's not something that we do every day. Closest to the casualty, and you can see that all of this has been completed by just 5 firefighters. So the most important thing to remember is go around and see the road safety guys. Make sure you wear your seatbelt every time you get in the car. make sure you've got a well-fitted child seat in your car, and make sure you drive safely. Now, is this by magic? As if it wasn't going to happen. We're very close. The last little nibble on the other side now. And hold your breath. And there's another third bar in there as well. Excellent. Well done. Big round of applause. So that was achieved by 6 bar photos, 5 bar photos, and a casualty rescue. Well done. So that concludes that demonstration for you. As you can see, it's not an easy one. That is very difficult. So give a big round of applause. Get to stand forward. Let's have a bow, everyone. Come on, don't be shy. A big thank you to Matt, one of our volunteers. That's his casualty there. Well done, guys. We'll have the next demonstration running shortly. Thank you very much.